Kat here, and today we have an upper body blast workout with burnouts. I know you guys really like these upper body workouts, so I'm like, hey, let's make some more. All right, so every exercise today is going to be 50 seconds on with 10 seconds rest. I'm gonna be using 15, 10s, and even 5s today. So go at your own pace, and let's have some fun. All right, let's do a warm up.
Roar. All right guys, we're gonna warm up nice and easy, starting with those arm circles. Just getting that blood to those arms. Nice and easy. That sounds really, really weird. Let's get the blood to the arms. Okay, reverse. You know, just a little stuff. All right, go ahead. Crisscross the arms in front. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. 3, 2, 1, and I'm going to grab the lightest weights I have. If you have water bottles, you can use those. If you don't have any weights, your arms do weigh something. So just go through those motions. Bring it up, front raise, side raise. Front raise, and side raise. Bend the elbows slightly, bring it slightly in front on those side raises. And you don't need to go up like, don't go up like this, okay? Make sure dumbbells are facing, or sorry, palms are facing down. Let's go one more on each side. You should start to feel the burn on those shoulders. And go ahead, shaky, shaky, shaky. All right, let's go with some hammer curls. So I want you to focus on curling your shoulder blades back, or rolling your shoulder blades back. Keep your core nice and strong. Squeezing your biceps as hard as you can, and then bringing it down. We're not using a lot of weight because we're just warming up, so we're getting ready. Now, I want you to focus on the form here, though. You don't want to bring it in front like this. Don't have your elbows flared out in front of you. And you want to make sure you're not hyperextending the spine. You don't want to go back like that. So I just want to get those corrections down before we get into the real good stuff. Go two more, squeezing, last one. All right, let's get those triceps. So, bring those dumbbells together. I'm sorry for anyone I offended with my awful British accent. And bring it up. My friends in the UK are like, yeah, you sound really posh and awful. And I'm like, sorry, it's awful, I'm sorry. All right, let's go 3, 2, last one. Go ahead, put those dumbbells down. All right, so left foot forward. You're gonna bring that right arm into big circles, big rotations, warming up those shoulders. There's so many people with shoulder issues. Bring it back. Some of it comes from not warming up enough, not warming up properly, not rehabbing as they should. So make sure you're taking care of yourself through stretches after this workout. I'm gonna go ahead and bring it other side. Big rotations. And bring it back. Woo! Almost there, guys. All right, shaky, shaky, shaky. Crisscross one more time. And we are going to get started. Let's do this. Roar. Okay, it's 10 seconds. We have single arm Arnold presses. It's a mouthful, but I'm gonna grab the 10s for this one. I'm gonna have dumbbells in front of me, palms facing towards me, wrist straight. You're gonna twist one, bring it back. Twist the other, bring it back. Remember, these are 50 second circuits, so pace yourself, okay? Woo! Press it up, bring it back. Make sure you're not bringing your traps in a lot of these exercises. A lot of the time people shrug up like this and they tense up, but shake it out, relax, roll out the shoulders, bring it back, and focus on the muscles you're supposed to be working. So in this one, it's mainly the anterior deltoid. So right here, front. You will feel it a bit in those biceps. They hold it in front of the face. Woo! Ooh, that's fun. But anterior deltoid should be the main part. Squeezing that core. Okay, Zatman curls are next. Woo! I'm gonna keep this weight. So just like a bicep curl, roll the shoulder blades back and down, palms facing out. Squeeze those biceps. I'm gonna bring it up, turn, and then slowly come down. So you're working on those forearms too. So squeeze hard as you can, turn, and then bring it back. Focus on the muscles you're supposed to be feeling. Squeeze, biceps, turn, forearms, feeling it, down, and down. Yes. All right, curl, turn, and back. Bring it back. Curl, turn, and back. See, this is fun. This is fun. You can have fun when you're working out. And I don't put music in my workouts. That's how I liked to work out to home workout videos. So That way I could add my own music in, so that's what you guys can do too. And plus I don't have to worry about copyright, so that's kind of nice. And down. Alright. Supine, front raised, T on. Okay, so palms are going to be facing up like this. You might have to drop the weight, bend the elbows slightly. So you're bringing up shoulder height, bring it out, back, and down, okay? So anterior deltoids here, bring it back, squeezing the back so the back's gonna feel it, and down. Forearms are working the whole time. Biceps are also going to feel it. You don't need a lot of weight for this. So if you have eights, fives, twos, use those, okay? Bend the elbows slightly. Ooh, those shoulders. It's a lot of shoulders today because everyone likes to have that cap for their shoulders. Oof. And down. Almost there. 10 seconds. You know it's good when you do that shuffle. You're like readjusting. You're like, this is right. This one feels good. And then you're like, nope, nope. Okay. All right. Concentration curls are next. I'm going to use one, 15. So I'm gonna come down and pretty much gonna squat. You can squat, you can lean forward on one. You just wanna press your arm up against a point where you're only using your bicep, squeezing. Squeeze, get that awesome squeeze. Your bodybuilder. Now, if you need to, if you have a chair, you can use that. If you have a bench like this, you can use this. And squeeze, look at your bicep, and tell yourself how awesome you are. Okay, now make sure when you're doing this, I'll come a little bit closer for this, your wrist isn't going like this, okay? You want to keep it nice and straight, squeezing that bicep and bringing it down nice and controlled. That control on the way down builds muscle too, okay? Stretching out that muscle will pretty much tear it, which builds it. All right, seems weird. So we're gonna do the same arm, come into a static lunge. Left foot forward, I'm gonna bring that arm back into a row, and then bring it back. Row, bring it back. So this is for that back. Oh my gosh, I forgot a shin right here. Okay, sorry. You're gonna feel it right here. A lot of people mistake it, and they go up like this, they engage the traps. You wanna bring it towards your hip. So bring it back towards your hip, squeeze. You don't need a ton of weight for this one. Feel it in those lats. Like I'm feeling it now. Woo! So even if you're used to, because like I can row up to 70, I think, the last time I checked. But with this 15, I can still feel it. So you don't always need a ton of weight. Okay. Woo! All right, concentration curls are next. We're gonna go to the other side. You're welcome to sit down. I prefer it. But if you don't have a bench or anything, you know that you can go in that static squat. So squeezing the bicep as hard as I can, nice and controlled. If you ever get stuck or you're like, oh, I can't do anymore, here, take your other hand, gently bring it up, and if you can, you're gonna control it on the way down alone. Alone. So alone. Squeeze. As hard as you can. Urgh. So fun. Urgh. I love it. I love it. Almost there. Squeeze. Finish it out, guys. You know what's next. Athletes. Okay. So now we have the static lunge rows. Now we're going to go back to shoulders. Okay, so come in that static lunge, shaky shaky. If you don't feel like working legs at all, you can go ahead and use a bench instead to do these rows and just concentrate mainly on that back one. You have options here. Good God. Squeeze. Okay, so we're gonna have three more moves after this. Whoops, and then we're gonna have a small burnout because it's fun. It's only a 2-minute burnout, so it's not that bad. But we'll have three moves, and you have 10 reps of each. And you're going to go through as many times as you can without having a break. Why? Because we can. Good God. 10 seconds. Woo! Squeeze. Almost there. Let's finish out. 3, 2, 1. Okay, so this is an old school move I had a long time ago. Grocery bag. Grocery bag punches. Some of you are like, oh my god. So you hold it like you have grocery bags, not holding it to your side, bring it out, twist and punch. Okay, I'm only using 5 for this one. You really don't need to use too much weight because you want to hold it out like this. Try not to rest it on those sides. Keep that core strong. Keep it nice and controlled. I like this one. So it's like challenge accepted. I'm only taking one trip to from my car to my apartment to get these groceries in. Yes. Good. 15 seconds, guys. After this, you got a push-up. Ugh. With a down dog push-up. You haven't done that in forever. I don't do push-ups too often. 3, 2, 1. Okay. 9 more at least. Okay. So one push-up, one down dog push-up. If you can't do down dog push-ups, I just want you to push back. I'll show you. So, regular push-up, nice neutral neck. Bring it back, down dog push-up. Bring the crown of the head down. Now, if you can't do that, at least do here. Push back, come back. Or you can always come down to the knees, push up, come up, and then push back. Okay, so you have a bunch of options here. You can just stick with push-ups. And then, whoops, push back. Woo! I actually like these down dog push-ups. They're fun. They're so fun! Back, forward, back, nice and neutral, back, finish it out, hop, oh, all right, woo, all right, we got one more before we get to that first burnout, pronated curls, we're working on the forearms, I'm only going to use 10s in this one, you don't need a ton of weight, so remember not to curl your wrists, roll your shoulder blades back and down, palms down, curl. Working on the forearms. Forearms get neglected sometimes, you know? A lot of people think that they only need to work them through other exercises, deadlifts. But you still want to strengthen them. Otherwise, if you strengthen like your tricep and your bicep too much and you neglect those forearms, there's going to be a big imbalance. And then you can get stuff like golfer's elbow. It's no bueno. So prevent it. Before fixing it, prevent it so it doesn't need to be fixed. Ooh, my forearm's on fire. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. I guess 10 seconds. We're going to start with 10 bicep curls, then go into 10 back rows, and then 10 bent arm raises. Switch the weights where you need to. Go at your own pace. 2 minutes. So, 10 curls. 1, 2, oh baby. 3, 4, 5, almost there, 6, 7, finish it out, 8, 9, one more, and 10. All right, so palms are gonna be facing towards each other, lean forward into chair pose, 1, 2, 3, squeezing the shoulder blades to go together, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 bent arm raises. I'm going to drop the weight down to 10. Have those arms at 90. Raise it. So feel some forearms. Woo! After what we just did. 4, 5. Keep it going. Relax the traps. 6, 7, 8. Keep it going. 9. Roar. 10. Out. All right. Bicep curls. 1 minute. 1, 2. Don't swing them. 3, 4, nice and controlled. 5, 6, you can do 1 at a time if you need to. 7, 8, 9, more. 10, woo! Oh baby, lean forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, keep going. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, more. 10, woo, bent arm raises, this is it. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shoulders. 7, 8, 9, 10 Curls for as long as you can. Curl. Oh, okay. All right, guys, that was the first burnout. Yay! Rear delt flies are next. These are super neglected. So you want to work back of the shoulder. We always work front, we always work side, we gotta work rear. So palms facing towards each other, bring it out. Bring it out. Now, what I don't want to do is, you don't want to bring it back like this, okay? Yeah, let's work in the back, but we want to work right here. So you want to bring it more out to the side, so your arms into a T. I'm using fives, and I honestly, in my regular, like, when I'm doing just strength training like this, I use fives. Really just concentrate on those muscles, bringing up your arms. 10 seconds. Finish it out. Ooh, baby. Oof. Okay. Woo! Clean and press. So clean and press on one side. You only need one weight. Now you will be using a bit of your legs on this one. I'm just gonna sneak that in there. Woo! Okay, so you're gonna sink down, squeeze your butt, bring it up, press back down. Sink it. Bring it up. Press, back, down. Same arm the whole time. We have the other arm after this. Because why not? Hello, shoulders. We love you. Well, I love you too. Aw. Sink it. Hup. Press, back, down. Stay strong. We got this. We freaking got this. Whether we like it or not. Press. 10 seconds. Up, back. Up, back, down. Finish it. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Other side, your shoulders should feel that. When we're pressing like that, it's mainly the anterior deltoid. So you can see how we do so much anterior work that we need to work those rear delts too. Press, back, down. Sink it. Up. Down. Hup. When in doubt, smile it out. I just made that up. It sounds legit though, right? Like, if you're having a bad day, just smile. And then your brain's like, you're insane. And then you're like, I am. And then you can both laugh about it. See, it works. Works out. Hup. Press back down. After this, got some back work.
Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Tell me more about back work. Okay.
3, 2, 1. Plank rows. So, I'm going to use these 15s. I'm going to come to a plank. Honestly, I think I'm not going to plank on the dumbbells. Me personally, they usually hurt. So, bring it up. Switch. Back. Switch. Just like in static lunge rows. You want to make sure you're bringing it back towards the hip, not bringing it up like this. And you want to try not to twist the hips too much. You want to stay stabilized, and you want your torso as parallel to the ground as you can. Let's try it on the dumbbells. It's just so much cleaner when you do it like this. So much more fluid. It's not that bad. Woo! 10 seconds. Woohoo! Keep going! 5, 3, 2, 1. Done! Alright. Oh, my lats. Oh, my lanta. Static lunge flies. Okay, let's grab some fives. If I had eights, I would use those. So, come into a lunge. You're gonna lean forward, neck neutral. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. You don't need a ton of weight for this one. Make sure your neck isn't like this. Make sure it's not up like this. Keep it neutral with that spine. Now if you're like, Kat, I'm not working legs today. So you can always come into a chair pose, back nice and flat. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Okay? I get it. It might be leg day, it might have been leg day. Or you might be having some knee injuries that you're recovering from and you did not sign up for lower body. It's cool, man. Squeeze. Almost there. 3, 2, 1. Oof. Oh, baby. All right, we have the other side. Other side. So if you have this again, in chair pose, actually I want you to do something different. You're gonna have palms facing up and you're gonna roll like this instead. So if you're in that chair pose, I want you to switch it up like this. If not, then you have the other side. Why am I doing that? Because it makes it interesting. I don't want you to be bored. That's dumb. That's not why you're here. Squeeze. Remember, just because I'm doing something doesn't mean you need to do that exact move. As long as you're doing another move safely, it's working similar muscles, you're good. Just have fun. Have fun. 15 seconds. This is why I'm not using a big amount of weight. 10 seconds. Finish it. 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay. Whew. Rotating side. Plank dip. I'm not gonna use weights. That would feel like it. So, come to a plank position. Yes. Okay. And then you're gonna twist right here, side dip, and then switch. Twist, side dip, switch. Now, if you want to, you can always come down to the knees, twist, dip, and back. Another option is coming down to the forearms, twist, dip. You can also take out the dip. So, as you can see, there's a bunch of options for everyone. Keep going. We are almost done with our workout. It's very exciting. I'm excited. Woohoo! Up, twist, back. Ooh, my obliques. I feel it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Twist. Okay. So, next move. We have upper body mountain climbers. This is working the shoulders. There's gonna be a few options for this one. Use a mat, carpet, whatever you want to make it more comfortable. Keeping your hips as close or as straight as possible, down, down, up, up. Yes, this is working core, but your shoulders are also gonna feel it. Now, if you wanna make it more challenging, you're gonna be in Sphinx pose. Press up, whoop, and then bring it down. Press up. Bring it down, another option, up, up, down, down, okay? So, totally up to you. I like Sphinx. It's fun, keep your core strong. So you don't need to do one leg, you can go on your knees. But if you can, one leg, you're gonna bring it up, push up, kick under, and switch. Up, push up, kick under, and switch. Another option, push up on your knees, come up, and then you can do a little knee twist instead. Okay? Push up, come up, twist that knee. Still working the core. Woo! And kick. Press. And kick. Whoop. It requires balance. Push. Kick under. Switch. Push. Kick under. And switch. Ugh. Oh my gosh. That is tough. Super tough. Okay, skull crushers. I'm gonna grab the 15s. Finishing out with triceps, then we have our burnout. Okay, so lay down, bring it up, bend those elbows, press it up. Let's have the dumbbells touching each other. Press it up. Inhale down, exhale, straighten out the arms. Okay, you should feel the triceps in the back of the arms, opposite of where the biceps are. Whew. Inhale. Exhale, control it up. Make sure you're not bringing your arms back like that. You're only bringing your forearms down. Press it up. Don't hit yourself. I've done it. It's not that fun. I promise. Inhale. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale. Finish it out. Okay. All right, guys. This is it. Last 2 minutes. I'm going to use only fives. We have front raise, 10 front raises, 10 side raises, 10 shoulder presses. So this is shoulder burnout. Why? Because it's possible. Okay. So bring it up. Remember to relax the traps. 3, 4. Remember, it's nonstop. 5, 6. Make sure you're using anterior deltoids for this. I think that's 10. Sorry. That's what happens when you talk. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice and controlled. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, shoulder presses. 1, 2, 3, oof, 4, 5. Can you see why I'm only using in fives? 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, front raises. So if you read one of my newest Instagram posts, this is of me flexing in Iceland. I wrote 10 things that I wish I knew before I started fitness. And one of them is you don't always need to use crazy heavy weights. And this is an example of one. I was like, sometimes I only use 5 pounds for like shoulder work. Like this. 2, 3. The burn is crazy. 4. Woo! 5, 6. Keep going. 7, 8. There's that shuffle. 9. One more. 10. All right, let's finish it up. We've got 30 seconds, guys. 1, 2, 3. Oof. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh my God. 10. Ah! Keep going. 15 seconds. Do what you can. 1, 2, 3. We're crazy. 4. 10 seconds. 5. Finish it. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One side raise. Okay, done. Done. We are done with this workout. Hopefully your shoulders are burning like crazy. We're gonna stretch it out. Make sure you stretch it out, okay? If you are leaving me though, if you are doing this workout again, if you do another one by clicking the eye, please do like this video before you go. Share it with friends and family on Facebook, Twitter, etc. It really helps me out. I want to help as many people as possible. So thank you so much. All right, guys, shoulder burn like crazy. Let's go ahead, left arm across the body and pull. Might feel super tight. You can go ahead and look over that left shoulder. So if you're leaving the house after this, putting on a jacket might be hard. You might feel super swole, as they call it. Shake it out. Let's get the same arm up and back. Get those triceps. So don't be too surprised. Make sure you keep on moving throughout the day. Drink a bunch of water. Go ahead, shake it out. Oof. Oh my gosh. All right. I love it. Right arm across the body and pull. It's such a weird, awful, awesome feeling. Finishing a workout, feeling that burn, that swoleness. And shake it out. Same arm on the back. Pull. Get that flexibility, mobility. Yeah. Breathe. Go ahead, shake it out. All right, clasp the hands and back. Pull down. Drop that neck back. Relax the eyes, the face, the mouth. Everything. Go ahead, bring it back to center. Drop that neck over to the right, and you can move it left to right, side to side, on that right side. And if you find a super tight spot, stay there and breathe. Bring it back to center, other side. Oh, there it is. Go ahead, bring it back to center. Oof. Oofa. All right. Camera's blinking at me. That's good. All right. If you have a wall, hopefully you have a wall, you're going to place your hand, the palm on it, and you're going to look the other way. You should feel this on the anterior shoulder blade. reaching into your chest, which is awesome because we worked your anterior deltoid so much, interior shoulder blade, interior deltoid. And our head, and shake it out for the other side. So wonderful. Shaky, shaky, shaky. All right, guys, last one. Clasp the hands in front. Pull the shoulders in. Big inhale. And exhale, we are done for today. Yay!
We did it. You guys did it. We completed our crazy awesome upper body blast for today with 2 burnouts. So that was awesome. Before you go, please do like this video and go ahead and pet the kitty to subscribe for more awesome workouts with me every Monday. If you want to leave a comment below, that'd be awesome. Let me know which move is your favorite today, what's burning, what workouts you want to see in the future. I would love to hear it. I would love to hear from you guys. So please do comment. Don't forget to follow me at @KatMoosneyFitness. See that Instagram post I posted. And you can also see it on my Facebook page. All right, I will see you guys soon. I hope you guys have an amazing day. And yeah, roar!